So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session guys, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant, which are important for each and every government exam of the country and of the central government and also of the state government. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Iska link you will find in the description, and here you will get the PDF of this session, and you can also connect me here. This is my Instagram ID. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which is regarding the PM Saubhagya Yojana. So the question is, consider the following statements with respect to PM Saubhagya Yojana and you have to identify the correct statement. Now, first of all, the thing is, why we are discussing about PM Saubhagya Yojana? The scheme was launched in 2017, so there must be some news regarding this. So guys, yes, the news is that this scheme has completed 4 years of implementation. The scheme has completed 4 years of implementation, and hence it was in news, and hence we are discussing about this particular scheme. All right. So let's talk about the scheme. So agar scheme news mein hai, then we have to discuss about that particular scheme, obviously. So let's talk about the scheme. So remember guys, the objective of this scheme. What is the full form of Saubhagya? Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana, which means the government is intended to provide electricity to all the households across the country, right? So the objective guys of this particular scheme is to ensure the last mile connectivity and electricity connection to all the unelectrified households in the country. All the unelectrified households in the country ko electrification provide karane ka objective hai of this particular scheme. And those areas which are inaccessible or which are the remote areas, there what government is doing, they are providing solar photovoltaic based standalone systems. This is for those areas which are remote and which are inaccessible, where grid connection system is not possible, all right. And also to achieve universal household electrification by providing financial assistance to the power distribution companies. Okay, so basically the basic objective of this scheme is to provide electricity to all the households across the country. And where the grid connection is not possible, they are providing solar photovoltaic based standalone systems, thereby achieving the 100% electrification of the country. This is the objective. This scheme, guys, remember, it is being implemented by Ministry of Power. Ministry of Power, which is headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. All right. Mr. R.K. Singh, his Lok Sabha constituency is Ara in Bihar. Moving ahead to other things, the nodal agency to implement this particular scheme is REC, which stands for Rural Electrification Corporation Limited. The scheme was launched in the year 2017, and the total cost which was there for this particular scheme is ₹16,320 crores, and out of this 12,320 crores was the budgetary allocation. All right, moving ahead, so eligible entities, ab yahan pe kaun kaun eligible hai to get the benefit of this scheme. So all the discoms will get the financial assistance, including private or the state managed discoms. Discoms means distribution companies. All right. Iske alawa, non-poor urban households are excluded of this scheme. Those urban people who are non-poor are excluded under this scheme because they are, apne aap hi wo electrification apne ghar ka kar sakte hain. All right. The beneficiaries are identified on the basis of SECC, Socioeconomic Caste Census 2011 data. All right. Now these are the eligibility for a household to get the benefit under this particular scheme. These are the 7 criteria, and a family and a household having any one of the 7 criteria is eligible to get the benefit. Now what are these 7 criteria? Households with only room, kaccha wall and kaccha roof, no adult member between the age of 16 and 59. Guys, this is not important to remember. Agar ho jata hai to achhi baat hai, because these days they are asking anything, so I would recommend ki isko koshish karo yaad karne ki, but agar nahi hota hai to zyada zor lagane ki zarurat nahi hai. Female headed households with no male member between the age of 16 and 59, household with disabled member and no able bodied member, adult member, SC or ST household, household with no literate adult above 25 years, and then we have landless households deriving major income from manual casual labor. Okay, so these are the 7 criteria, and any household fulfilling any one of the criteria is eligible to get the benefit under this particular scheme. They will be provided a free electrification of their houses. Moving ahead to other things about this scheme. So there are some automatic inclusion criteria, and of course there are some automatic exclusion criteria also. Exclusion criteria, if you are an income taxpayer, if you are a government servant, if you are an MP, if you are an MLA, so these are some of the automatic exclusion criteria, which are 14 in number. And of course, you don't have to remember the 14 exclusion criteria. But yes, there are only 5 inclusion criteria that you have to remember. Number 1 is the households without shelter, destitute, living on alms, manual scavenger families, primitive tribal groups, and legally released bonded labor. Now you must be wondering that household without shelter. Household without shelter का क्या मतलब हुआ? A person without shelter, what will he do of the electricity? तो इसके बारे में जो clarification है वो बहुत ज़्यादा अच्छी नहीं दे रखी किसी भी document में. I have searched it from the various sources, but there is no explanation regarding this. They are just saying household without shelter. So I was also unable to understand what is the meaning of this. जो मैं सबसे पास तक समझ पाया वो ये था, इसका मतलब कि अगर कोई पर्सन जिसके पास मान लो कि एक कमरा है सिर्फ, ठीक है, और उसमें कोई पार्टीशन नहीं है, सो दैट हाउस होल्ड दे आर कंसीडरिंग एज हाउस होल्ड विदाउट शेल्टर. ओके, बट ऑफकोर्स ये मेरा एक अंडरस्टैंडिंग है, ये 100% कहीं पर भी लिखा नहीं है कि इन्होंने वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस हाउस होल्ड विदाउट शेल्टर. ऑलराइट, नाउ फॉर हाउस होल्ड विच आर नॉट एलिजिबल. सो इफ आई एम नॉट एलिजिबल अंडर दिस स्कीम, कैन आई गेट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी city under this particular scheme? Yes, I can. Rupees 500 per household is charged as one time fee in 10 installments of rupees 50 each. Okay, for that I have to give rupees 500 installation charges, and that will be paid in 10 equal installments of rupees 50 each. All right, moving ahead to other things. Now this is the funding pattern, how the government is providing funding pattern. ठीक है, सो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ स्टेट्स. द स्कीम यू नो प्रोवाइड्स फंड टू द स्टेट्स बेस्ड ऑन टू टाइप्स ऑफ स्टेट्स. वन इज द स्पेशल कैटेगरी स्टेट्स एंड अदर, दूसरा क्या है, अदर स्टेट्स. स्पेशल कैटेगरी स्टेट्स में कौन कौन है, विच आर द स्टेट्स इन द स्पेशल कैटेगरी स्टेट्स, दीज आर ऑल द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न स्टेट्स आर देयर. देन वी हैव उत्तराखंड, देन वी हैव हिमाचल प्रदेश, देन वी हैव यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ अंडमान एंड निकोबार, देन वी हैव लक्षद्वीप एंड जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. उन्होंने कभी लद्दाख के बारे में कुछ बताया नहीं अभी तक. ऑफकोर्स लद्दाख के यूटी बनने से पहले से स्कीम चली आ रही है 2017 से, और उसके बाद उन्होंने लद्दाख के बारे में कुछ बताया नहीं, सो आई विल नॉट टेल यू दैट ऑल्सो. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, इन केस ऑफ स्पेशल कैटेगरी 85% ग्रांट विल बी गिवन बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, 5% विल बी बोर्न बाय द यूटिलिटी और द स्टेट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन, एंड द लोन्स और लोन्स फ्रॉम द बैंक्स ऑफ फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन रेस्ट 10%. While in the case of other state, this percentage is 60, 10 and 30. Alright. So this is the funding pattern of this particular scheme. So this was about the scheme, guys. And now let's come back to the question. The question says, you have to identify the correct statement. And also remember that they are saying that 2.82 crore households have been provided with the electricity under this particular scheme till now. Okay. So these are the 5 statements, and out of which you have to identify the correct one. The scheme was launched in 2016. Is that 2016? No, that's 2017. Then there are 5 automatic inclusion and 14 automatic exclusion criteria. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Non-poor urban households are eligible under the scheme. No, they are not. Total outlay for the scheme is 16,320 crores. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Once again, yes. Rural Electrification Corporation is the nodal agency to implement this scheme. So, second, fourth and fifth are correct, which means option C will be the correct answer. So, I hope guys this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2, which is a quite easy question. Question number 2, I hope you all know this. With which of the following organizations, Zoological Survey of India has signed an MOU that will be focused on mutually beneficial projects based on the study of fauna of India. So with which organization this MOU has been signed by Zoological Survey of India, and this MOU will be focused on mutually beneficial projects which are based on the research on fauna. Alright. So this organization, guys, remember, is the National History Museum London. National History Museum London. And as the question says that this MOU will be focused on mutually beneficial product based on the study of fauna of India. And through this MOU, the provisions of two conventions will be implemented. One is CITE and one is CBD, Convention on Biological Diversity. And what is this CITE? This is Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild fauna and flora. This should be flora. This is not, both cannot be fauna. And 1992 convention on biological diversity. This MOU, the tenure of this MOU guys is 5 years. Do remember this also. Alright. So itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada padhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. That is more than enough about this particular news. And remember, the correct answer is what? National History Museum, which is located in London. Option A will be the correct answer. Now let's move ahead to question number 3, which is again a very easy, but it is a very, very important question. In which district Odisha's first ever Tassar Silk Yarn Production Center has been set up by KVIC? Remember, KVIC chairperson is Mr. V.K. Saxena, Vinay Kumar Saxena, and it is headquartered in New Delhi. New Delhi is the headquarter, and the question is regarding the Odisha's first Tassar Silk Yarn Production Center. So remember, it has been set up in Cuttack district at a place, which is known as Chaudhwar. चौधवार नाम की जगह पे कटक डिस्ट्रिक्ट में उड़ीसा के ये उड़ीसा का सबसे पहला टसर सिल्क यार्न प्रोडक्शन सेंटर एस्टैब्लिश हुआ है. एंड ऑफ कोर्स दिस सेंटर विल इंश्योर लोकल अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ टसर सिल्क एंड इट विल बूस्ट द लोकल एम्प्लॉयमेंट आल्सो. ऑलराइट, इट इज एस्टिमेटेड दैट दिस सेंटर विल क्रिएट डायरेक्ट एम्प्लॉयमेंट ऑफ 50 आर्टिसंस इंक्लूडिंग 34 वुमेन. एंड अदर देन दिस सेंटर विल प्रोवाइड लाइवलीहुड सपोर्ट टू ओवर 300 ट्राइबल फार्मर्स एंगेज्ड इन कोकून फार्मिंग. The cost of setting up this particular center is guys rupees 75 lakhs and the production capacity of this is 200 kg of silk yarn worth rupees 94 lakh in 1 year. Okay, so isme itna hi padhenge, isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Now let's come back to the question. The correct answer to this question guys is option B, Cuttack. In Cuttack at a place Chaudhwar, this Odisha's very first tressor silk production center has been established. Moving ahead to question number 4, again very important question. How many Divyangjans, PWDs, person with disabilities, have been presented the Hunar Baz Awards by Hyderabad based National Institute of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj and Ministry of Rural Development? Who is the minister? Mr. Giriraj Singh. His Lok Sabha constituency is Begusarai, and of course he is also the minister of Panchayati Raj. Alright, so the number of PWDs guys are 75. So the 75 person with disabilities from 15 states have been presented this award, which is known as Hunar Baz Award by National Institute of Panchayati Raj and Rural Development, which is in Hyderabad, along with the Ministry of Rural Development. All right, and these awards guys are given to those person with disabilities who are the beneficiaries of, who have got training under the DDU-GKY and R-SETI schemes. DDU-GKY and R-SETI, Rural Self Employment Training Institute scheme. All right, इसमें भी इतना ही पढ़ेंगे. And remember, इसमें आपके question दो तरीके से बन सकते हैं कि under which schemes, कौन से schemes के beneficiaries को Hunar Baz Awards मिले थे. So there are two schemes, DDU-GKY and R-SETI, R-SETI scheme. All right. So 75 is the correct answer to this question. I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 5, which is the last question and the very, very important question, because this is regarding the PMFME exam, PMFME scheme, and for the upcoming NABARD exam means this very important because it is directly related to the food processing industry, you all know. So the Ministry of Food Processing Industry, now who is the minister, can you tell me, write down in the comments, along with the Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs. Housing and Urban Affairs ka main bata deta hu, Hardeep Singh Puri hai, theek hai. Has launched seed capital module under PMFME scheme. What is PMFME? Prime Minister Formalization of Micro Food Processing Enterprises. Okay. How much amount of seed funding can be availed by a member of SHG under this module? And of course, SHG means self-help groups. So remember guys, the news is that the Ministry of Food Processing Industry along with Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has launched seed capital module under PMFME scheme on DAY-NULM. National Urban Livelihood Mission MIS portal. MIS stands for Management Information System, which means that the beneficiaries, the urban SHG beneficiaries of DAY-NULM will be provided with the seed capital funding under the PMFME schemes. Okay, those urban SHG members, those urban SHG beneficiaries of DAY-NULM which are getting benefits under DAY-NULM will be provided with this seed capital funding under PMFME. Okay, मतलब पीएमएफएमई में देयर इज नथिंग न्यू बिकॉज दे आर ऑलरेडी प्रोवाइडिंग रुपीज 40,000 एट सीड कैपिटल टू वेरियस एसएचजी बट नाउ द बेनिफिशियरीज ऑफ डे एनयूएलएम एंड द प्रोविजन ऑफ पीएमएफएमई इज नाउ लिंक्ड ओके इनको आपस में क्या कर दिया लिंक कर दिया है दिस एमओयू दिस पार्टनरशिप has been there is there to provide seed capital assistance to the members of SHG working in the food processing sector of course these SHG should be working in the food processing center because the scheme is regarding that only and how much amount of seed funding that should be 40,000 40,000 rupees ka seed capital funding they will get now talking about PM FME so remember guys it is a centrally sponsored scheme hai ye and it is it has the objective to enhance the competitiveness of the माइक्रो फूड प्रोसेसिंग एंटरप्राइजेस ओके दे विल बी प्रोवाइडेड विद द टेक्निकल सपोर्ट दे विल बी प्रोवाइडेड विद द मार्केटिंग सपोर्ट बिजनेस सपोर्ट एंड अदर टाइप्स ऑफ सपोर्ट ऑल्सो टोटल आउटले ऑफ दिस स्कीम इज 10,000 crore एंड इसका जो वो है टेन्योर है इस स्कीम का दैट इज 2021 to 2024-25 दिस शुड बी 2024 ओके एंड इट इज एस्टिमेटेड दैट दिस Scheme will provide benefit to 2 lakh micro food processing enterprises in the terms of technical support, business support and marketing support. So there are various type of support that is being provided under PMFME. And this scheme ke baare mein agar detail mein jaana hai, to recently maine cover kiya hai PMFME before the NABARD phase 1 exam. So you can watch it from there. So let's come back to the question. How much amount of seed funding? That's 40,000. Option D will be the correct answer. It is guys very important. So do remember this. और इसमें क्वेश्चन ऐसा भी आ सकता है कि कौन सी स्कीम के अंडर द प्राइम दिस पीएमएफएमई स्कीम इज प्रोवाइडिंग रुपीज 40,000 टू द यू नो अर्बन एसएचजी बेनिफिशियरीज तो डीएनयूएलएम वुड बी द आंसर इन दैट केस ओके सो दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन गाइस फॉर टुडे आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर एंड टुमारो गाइस आई विल ब्रिंग यू द सेशन ऑफ सेप्टेम्बर बेस्ट क्वेश्चंस कल शाम को होगा इसका सेशन 5 बजे या 6 बजे के अराउंड आई विल टेल यू आपको पता चल जाएगा यूट्यूब पे वो इवेंट आ जाएगा सो वी विल गेट टू नो अबाउट दैट टुमारो देयर विल बी सेशन ऑन सितंबर बेस्ट क्वेश्चन सो लाइव होगा अगर आपको और भी कुछ चीज़ें पूछनी है तो यू कैन कम लाइव एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन थैंक यू सो मच गुड बाय टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस